might be a tumor.
It's not a tumor.
Film Lounge presents...
Spoiler-free interview!
First you gotta do the truffle shuffle. Come on!
With Chris Gooch.
I'm the dude.
Last call.
Make it a double.
Hard day at the office. A lot of booze, such a small woman.
I don't get asked on a lot of second dates.
She's a hard-drinking, hot-tempered mess of a private eye, who's also capable of punching a hole through your chest. That might not seem like the recipe for the kind of person you want to hang out with, but you could definitely afford to lose 13 hours of your life getting to know Marvel and Netflix's new small-screen super-heroine, Jessica Jones.
In my line of work, you gotta know when to walk away. But some cases just won't let you go.
Yes, the sophomore follow-up to the smash hit series that was Daredevil from earlier this year is Jessica Jones. A private dick without the dick, living in Hell's Kitchen, who uses her wit, intelligence, smart mouth, and super strength, along with the ability to fly and consume copious amounts of alcohol, to solve whatever case needs to be solved. Just imagine Veronica Mars, but with superpowers and a bad drinking habit.
You're a PI?
I'm just trying to make a living, you know, booze costs money, usually.
When the Shore parents hired Jessica to help find their missing daughter, this reluctant superhero with severe PTSD becomes caught up in a deadly cat-and-mouse game with a man known as Kilgrave, who has the ability to control anyone with just a few simple words.
Yes? You'd like to invite me in? Absolutely.
Filled with the grit and darkness that had Daredevil leaving all other comic book TV series looking slack-jawed, Jessica Jones ups the dark tones with some really disturbing concepts and scenes touching on domestic abuse, sexual abuse, self-harm, and all those other feel-good, happy, fun-time things.
A couple words and you're his weapon.
No one else will die because of me.
One of the great things about this Netflix series is that it's a lot like watching just one 13-hour-long comic book movie. We aren't so dependent on having a freak-of-the-week approach to the storytelling that you often get from shows like The Flash, Arrow, and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. We essentially just have one long, overarching narrative sprinkled throughout with supporting characters' stories that, for the most part, serve a genuine purpose. Often one of the biggest clichés in comic book TV series and movies is the will-they-won't-they trope. The Flash does this, Arrow does this, Iron Man has done this for three films. But with Jessica Jones, the big question is, will they or won't they stop f***ing? Which is just so incredibly refreshing, as it's just great to see a real adult relationship fleshed out in the superhero genre. No pun intended, of course. One of the strongest elements of the show is its unflinching portrayal of abusive relationships and how the strong female characters handle and react to these situations. Kristen Ritter and Rachel Taylor are perfectly cast and bounce off each other so well. You can see a genuine friendship, and what is also really refreshing is that at no point are any of these female characters pining for men or succumbing to the other negative stereotypes associated with women in leading roles.
I don't know how you handle it. It's called whiskey.
The show itself also really comes alive whenever Mike Coulter's Luke Cage or David Tennant's Kilgrave are on screen. But both for completely different reasons. Luke Cage is calm and confident, not to mention indestructible. But in a surprise gender reversal, he plays a femme fatale to Ritter's hard-boiled detective.
Why?
Local? You hot? Drinking alone? Tends to attract customers. But hey, don't do me any favors.
Whereas Kilgrave is skin-crawlingly creepy, incredibly funny, and yet able to, on occasion, make you feel sorry for him despite some of the horrific things that he does.
For every year that you left me alone, stab yourself.
The show itself is not perfect. Admittedly, the slow burn approach can sometimes be a little too slow. There is a sudden and dramatic character change for one of the supporting cast, which really comes out of left field and is never really explained and doesn't really make sense when you think about how the character was first introduced. The show, much like Daredevil, is also continually building up several things, including a final confrontation. But unlike Daredevil, none of these things really pan out or pay off come the end of the final episode. The show teases everything, from flying to the Purple Man to the Man Without Fear, just to name a few. But honestly, I wouldn't be holding my breath for many of these things.
Kill you right here and right now.
But you won't, because you don't know what will happen when I die.
Overall, Jessica Jones is an absolute train wreck of a character, but with some great humor, charm, and strongly positive feminist messages, this is definitely the show you should be watching right now. It may not quite reach the lofty heights of Daredevil, but the tension this series ratchets up throughout its 13-episode run really does give the other hero of Hell's Kitchen a run for his money. Jessica Jones gets 4 3/4 stars out of 5. What are you doing? You need to be watching the show right now. Already watched it? Then watch it again!
All I have is my professional reputation.